Welcome to worship on this All Saints Sunday. In a sense, it's the church's Memorial Day Sunday. We remember those members who have passed away since last All Saints 2019. We mailed out the newsletter, but I didn't get mine, so I assume nobody got theirs. But in there, there'll be estimate of giving cards, and you don't have to bring them back until the end of the month. Stewardship Sunday we'll have November 15th. Next Sunday we'll have the 50th anniversary of being passed in congregation together. And there are new congregational directories on the parlor table. Please help yourselves to them. Poinsettia flowers can be ordered for Christmas Eve services by using the pew envelopes. Nancy, we still have hoagie sales. I think it's okay, they're available. Nancy, we have no announcements about the hamburger barbecue yet. All right, hamburger barbecue will be available. There'll be a sign-up sheet in the parlor.
Yeah, that's hanging on the bulletin board.
Bulletin board outside the church for you there. Yeah. Okay, good. Please stand for the confession. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Holy One, we confess that we are not awake for you. We are not faithful in using your gifts. We forget the least of our siblings. We do not see your beautiful image in one another. We are affected by sin that divides you from our community. Open our hearts to your coming. Open our eyes to see you in our neighbor. Open our hands to serve your creation. Amen. Beloved, we are God's children, and Jesus, our beloved, opens the door to us. Through Jesus, you are forgiven. By Jesus, you are welcome. In Jesus, you are called to rejoice. Let us live in the promises prepared for us from the foundation of the world.
Insert.
Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house, and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord. Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord. This is the feast of victory for our God. Alleluia. Together in one communion in the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Grant us grace to follow your blessed saints in lives of faith and commitment, and to know the inexpressible joys you have prepared for those who love you, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Revelation. After this I looked, and there was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, robed in white with palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, saying, "Salvation belongs to our God who is seated on the throne and to the Lamb." And all the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures, and they fell on their faces before the throne and worshiped God, saying, "Amen, blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, "Who are these robed in white, and where have they come from?" I said to him, "Sir, you are the one that knows." Then he said to me, "These are they who have come out of the great ordeal. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason, they are before the throne of God and worship him day and night within his temple. And the one who is seated on the throne will shelter them. They will hunger no more and thirst no more. The sun will not strike them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb at the center of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to springs of the water of life, and God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm is read responsively. I will bless the Lord at all times. The praise of God shall ever be in my mouth.
I will glory in the Lord, let the lowly hear and rejoice.
Proclaim with me the greatness of the Lord. Let us exalt God's name together.
I exalt the Lord, who answers me, and delivers me from all my prayers.
Look upon the Lord and be radiant, and let not your faces be ashamed.
I call in my affliction, and the Lord heard me, and saved me from all my troubles.
The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear the Lord and delivers them.
Nations see that the Lord is good. Happy are they who take refuge in God.
Fear the Lord, you saints of the Lord, for those who fear the Lord lack nothing.
The lives are in one who suffer from her, but those who seek the Lord lack nothing that is good.
O Lord, you redeem the life of your servants, and those who put their trust in you will not be punished. A reading from 1 John. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God, and that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that they did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we will be has not yet been revealed. What we do know is this. When he is revealed, we will be like him, for we will see him as he is. And all who have this hope in him purify themselves just as he is pure. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you, and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Dear friends in Christ, grace, mercy, and peace, from God our Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, amen. I'm not sure the world has ever felt as upside down in my lifetime that it has appeared in 2020, a global pandemic, accompanied economic crises, political division and discord, protests for justice and a better world for all people. And week after week, there seems to be a new catastrophe, a new story, or several, that cause us to roll up our eyes and think, now what? A year ago, life included parties, eating out in restaurants, happy hours, travel. It's more mundane activities included working in an office or a shop, going to church without masks and social distancing, shopping groceries, picking up kids from schools and hugging people. That world is gone now. And every single element of the normal life has been disrupted, destroyed, almost turned on its head. And the world we live in now seems strange, scary, and I don't mean scary Halloween scary. We don't know what the world holds in the future, with the upheaval and uncertainty, how long will it last? Many times in recent months, I thought the world is broken, maybe ending, that everything is messed up. And I long for the world that we had before, and I'm sure you do too, even with all the imperfections and all the injustices. It was a world in which we were comfortable in. The Beatitudes today, however, are a reminder that the world as we have generally encountered it is not the world that God intends for us or desires for us. And indeed, in many ways, God's desired world is an inversion of the world in which we feel comfortable and entitled to. With these eight strange, unexpected blessings, Jesus begins his Sermon on the Mount. He offers instruction, a parable, a promise, a command to his followers about the way God intends us to lead our lives, live our lives. It's significant, I think, that Jesus begins with these inverted blessings. So we are blessed. That's what Jesus says about us. You're blessed if you're poor. You're blessed if you mourn the loss of a loved one. You're blessed if you are meek and quiet-spirited. You're blessed if you're hungry. Blessed if you are merciful. Blessed if you live with good motives. Blessed if you seek peace. You're blessed if people treat you badly because of your faith. Funny. All our lives, and in almost every circumstance, we're taught that we are blessed when we are wealthy or powerful or successful, blessed if we're popular or if we're beautiful or if we're healthy or wise. When politicians end speeches, the most of them end by saying, "And may God bless America." Football players used to kneel and pray when they score a touchdown, but not when they miss a tackle. Business persons thank God for their success, but not for their failures. Beauty queens praise God when they win the crown, but not when they lose it. So, which is it? Are we blessed, as Jesus says, in all circumstances of life? Or are we blessed only when we have those measured qualities like money, power, comfort, success? For me, the answer to that is found in the words of a poem written by a theologian, Gerhard Frost, and he entitles it The Benediction. And I quote it, "Preschool, and she didn't like it. Standing in the shadows of the cloakroom, I sadly helped her work with her overshoes as the bell began to ring. With only a second to think, and my mind stumbled and raced, what could I say to her? Is there a word, O God? Give me a thought to anchor this day, to comfort this child who has tears in her eyes." And then it came. "You are blessed, little one. Remember, Granddaddy told you you were blessed." A quick caress and she was away. No, not quite. But just as when she was about to step out of my view, she turned and with a smile she said, "And you are blessed, Granddaddy." Of all the times I've received the blessing, alone or with other people, I remember best the benediction that ricocheted back to me from the heart of this smiling child. To be blessed means to know that we are loved and cared for deeply and forever. Families do it best. Friends can certainly make a difference in our lives. And over the years, I've seen churches, their members being a blessing to people. But I would submit to you today that to be blessed by God holds the very meaning of life, realizing that whatever happens to the stuff of this world, our possessions, our reputation, our successes and failures, to know that we are loved by the Creator of it all is the greatest blessing one can ever know. I think it's a powerful poem. And perhaps that's why we read the Beatitudes, the Sermon on the Mount on All Saints Sunday. Because we need a gentle and powerful reminder that we are loved, especially if we lost someone the past year that we weep for, knowing that they are wrapped in the blessing of God, that their hunger is over, their poverty has been met with plenty, and maybe they had persecutions in their life and now it's over, and maybe they had a life of pain but now it's joy. If you grieve the loss of a loved one today, then you are blessed. Because the God of creation reminds you that those loved ones are now in his care. I entitled this sermon, Blessings and Responsibilities, because last week, Reformation Sunday, I quoted various things from Martin Luther, but whenever I do that, I feel sometimes we might misunderstand him or think it's offensive, but mostly misunderstand it. Luther last week told us that we are gifted people. And of course, he is right. We have been given grace from a loving God. And nothing can make us worthy of God's love. Nothing we can do can come close to paying God for the gifts that we have. We cannot earn our salvation. But that doesn't mean that we can do nothing. Of course we can. As Christians, we have the responsibility to ensure that the stories and the message of the gospel is carried on to other people today and in the future. It's our duty to share the good news with others so they may know God's mercy. But, you know, when I quote Luther, I'm afraid that it may steer some people away and they might try to still earn their salvation. It's a gift. We cannot earn the gift. And it's not merely an option for us to do good things in our lives, but as Luther implies, it is our duty in response to God's love for us. In a few weeks, we'll have stewardship in our congregation. As I said, you didn't get the November newsletter yet, but there'll be a percentage of giving guide and a commitment card in there. There'll be some in the pew. The proposed budget for next year, I think, is a little over 1%. And you are asked to give proportionately as God has blessed you. But make no mistake, our stewardship is about we are saints and we are to live generous lives. Stewardship is not about money, but about the mission of the church, how we extend it to people around us. And it's our responsibility to prepare for those for the future as God has blessed us. And then ultimately it's about proclaiming to those who know God's love that we are a blessed community and blessed people. May God bless you as you invest in the ministry of the church so other generations may know the blessing as we remember these loved ones on this All Saints Sunday. Thanks be to God. Amen. let us confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Longing for Christ's reign to come among us, we pray for the outpouring of God's power on the church, the world, and all in need.
Lord of all the saints, we praise you for evangelists and martyrs who sacrifice as witness to your gospel across time and space. Inspire us by their courage to carry our faith to new people and places around us. Hear us, O God. Lord of every place, the universe proclaims your greatness from generation to generation. Bless the work of naturalists, conservationists, and park rangers who train our attention to the wonders of the world you have made. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Lord of every nation, guide this country, red states and blue states, rural voters and urban voters, young and old, as we share in another national election. Kindle hearts eager to understand our common needs and seek our common good. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Lord of every blessing, your Son's blessing came to those living with poverty, grief, hunger, thirst, and persecution. Shape our vision of the saints to match his own. Awaken in us your call to serve all who suffer. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Lord of every venture, anoint us with the missionary spirit of the early church. Bless all new missions of our synod, especially for those we name in our hearts or out loud.
Gracious God, we thank you for the celebration this year, 50 years of Lutheran women being ordained in the Evangelical Lutheran Church in America, 40 years of women of color being ordained.
Empower testimony from new communities of faith to shape a diverse witness to your saving power. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Thank you, dear Father, for all your saints. Thank you for the ones who shaped our faith and molded our lives. Thank you for the great heroes and martyrs, the scholars who have kept your church by your Spirit as being true to the gospel. Thank you for the nameless and forgotten faithful, known only to you, whose humble lives we commend to your care in the hope of eternal life. Thank you for joining us to Jesus and thereby to all your saints, past, present, and future. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Lord of every time, countless are the multitudes you have called by name and gathered to yourself. Comfort us as we grieve those who died in the past year, Mildred A. Ginder, Ronald L. Stevens, Ulrich S. Hubert, Patricia A. Mulholland, Teresa J. Kolar, S. Dawn Grubb, Harry R. Dre, Doris D. McDonald, William Force, Heather Heracle, and Helen Koenig. In faith, may we join with them in ceaseless prayers. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Receive our prayers in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior, until that day when you gather all creation around your throne, where you have reigned forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
Supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." To him all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, with the Holy Spirit, in your holy church, both now and forever. Blood of Christ shed for you. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Thank you.